Hello, we have already studied action potentials in cardiac myocyte and SA node in two separate videos. In this video, we will focus on what are the differences between the two and the reason behind them. Welcome back to nonstopneuron.com, where learning medical concepts is as easy as watching cartoons. Needless to say, if you haven't already watched both videos, I recommend watching them before continuing this video. You can find the links in the description. And if you have already watched them, let's get started with a quick revision. So the action potential in cardiac muscle looks like this. It has 5 phases. Phase 0 or upstroke is due to opening of fast sodium channels and rapid influx of sodium. Phase 1 or initial depolarization is due to closure of fast sodium channels and efflux of a small quantity of potassium through open potassium channels. Phase 2 or plateau is due to the opening of slow or L type of calcium channels leading to calcium influx and closure of potassium channels which prevents the potassium efflux. The calcium channels stay open for quite some time, so we get a long plateau. Then phase 3 or final repolarization is due to the closure of L-type calcium channels that prevent further calcium entry and opening of slow potassium channels leading to potassium efflux. Phase 4 is resting membrane potential till the next action potential. Resting membrane potential in myocyte is about minus 90 millivolt. So this was the action potential in the cardiac myocyte. Now the action potential in SA node. It looks like this. Here, the phase 4 or slow pacemaker potential is due to the slow entry of sodium and calcium. Phase 0 or upstroke is due to a rapid influx of calcium. And phase 3 or repolarization is due to cessation of calcium entry and exit of potassium ions. Resting membrane potential in SA node is about minus 60 millivolt. Now let's bring both the graphs side by side and see the differences. First, the resting membrane potential in SA node is about minus 60 millivolt, whereas that in the ventricular myocyte is about minus 90 millivolt. Thus, the resting membrane potential is less negative in the SA node as compared to that in the myocyte. The reason is, cells in SA node contain leaky sodium and calcium channels. Through these channels, sodium and calcium keep leaking into the cell. This entry of positively charged ions make the potential slightly less negative. The second difference is that phase 0 or upstroke is less steep in SA node as compared to that in the ventricular myocyte. The reason is, this upstroke is produced by fast sodium channels in myocytes, whereas it's produced by slow sodium and calcium channels in the SA node. Next, a characteristic feature of action potential in myocyte is a plateau. However, this is not seen in the action potential in the SA node. Next, phase 3 or repolarization is more gradual in the SA node as compared to that in the myocyte. And finally, phase 4. It's constant in the myocytes. Whereas in the SA node, the phase 4 shows slow diastolic depolarization. In fact, this is the thing that makes the SA node self-excitable. So these were all the differences. I hope this video makes your understanding of action potentials in cardiac myocytes and SA node clearer. Quick recap. In the SA node, the resting membrane potential is less negative, upstroke is less steep, there is no plateau, phase 3 is more gradual, and phase 4 shows slow diastolic depolarization. That's it for this video. If you feel this video will help your friends and colleagues, please share it with them too. And don't forget to subscribe because lots more to come. At Nonstop Neuron, learning medical concepts is as easy as watching cartoons. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.